energy difference between T2G and EG levels. Energy difference between T2G and EG levels. And one more word we have to use, that is P. What is that P indicates? The energy required for pairing of electron. So let us consider the two important conditions here. What are the important conditions? Actually, in case of fourth electron, there are two confusions. The two possibilities for fourth electron in D4 configuration, it may enters into T2G level or it may also enters into higher energetic EG level. So, is it enters into T2G level or EG level? It depends upon strength of the ligand as well as delta 0, energy difference between T2G and EG level, and P, the energy required for pairing of electron. For what is pairing of electron? Already three electrons enters into, each electron enter into dxy, dyz, dzx. When fourth electron wants to enters into dxy orbital, it have to pair with already existing electron. The amount of energy required to pair with that electron is called as pairing energy, generally represented as P. So let us have two conditions. In first condition, if delta 0 is greater than P, what is that? Energy difference between T2G and EG levels are greater than P. What is P here? Energy required for pairing of electron. Then fourth electron enters into T2G level and pairing takes place because of P having less energy than delta 0. And second condition, if delta 0 is less than P, that is the energy difference between T2G and EG is less than energy required for pairing of electron, then fourth electron enters into EG level. If fourth electrons enters into T2G level, the magnetic momentum decreases due to pairing of electron. Whereas if the fourth electron and fourth, fifth, sixth electrons if enters or occupies at higher energy level, then the magnetic momentum increases due to increase of unpaired electrons, the number of unpaired electrons. So this will be happened. Now the most important factor is this. This will depends upon strength of the ligand. How it influences? That means how the strength of the ligand can influences whether fourth electron enters into T2G orbital or T2G energy level or fourth electron enters into EG energy level. The simple concept, in the presence of weak field ligands, weak field ligands delta 0 or delta O is less than, in case of strong field ligands, the very simple. For example, I would like to consider a very weak ligand I minus. In such case, the 5 orbital degeneracy state orbitals can divide it into like this with a very less energy difference. Where the onto the same d orbital in which 5 orbitals are at degeneracy level, in case of strong field ligand like cyanide minus CN cyanide, then the energy difference between EG and T2G is very high. In such case, in this case, delta 0 is less than P. Then electron enters into EG level. In the presence of strong field ligand where delta O is greater than P, then the fourth electron will occupy lower energetic T2G level and pairing of electrons takes place. So this is crystal field stabilization, crystal field theory to explain six coordinated octahedral complexes. Similarly, the same crystal field theory is also useful . So let us consider CO, CN, taken 6, minus 3 is one complex, whereas CO, F6, minus 3 is another complex. The two are metal complexes. In this metal complex, or in first metal complex, the ligand is cyanide. In the spectrochemical series, we can identify cyanide is a strong field ligand, the strengthened ligand. Whereas in the second metal complex, the ligand is fluorine. Fluorine is a weak field ligand. So in these two cases, the 5d orbitals of, let us consider the oxidation state of cobalt in the first complex is CO plus 3. And will be represented as 3d6 4s 0. That means the d orbital with 6 electrons. So these 6 electrons are these 5 d orbitals which are present in degeneracy level in the presence of ligand split into two energy levels. One is Eg and one is T2g. So we have to remember that the energy difference between Eg and T2g is must be more. Why? Because cyanide is a strong field ligand. In the presence of strong field ligand, the two orbitals dx square y square and dz square orbitals, which may be identified at Eg energy level, will have greater affinity or greater energy than T2g, the orbitals present at T2g energy level. So how many orbitals are present? Dxy, dyz, dzx. Come to this, when energy difference between T2g, Eg energy levels are more, in such case delta O must be greater than P. In such cases, out of the 6 electrons present in cobalt, the first electron enters here, second electron enters here, third electron enters here. Similarly, the fourth electron again enters into the same T2g energy level. Why? Because if the energy difference is more, delta 0 is highly greater than P, so pairing easily takes place, the fifth electron and sixth electron. Then the resulting compound, which shows pairing of orbitals and produces inner field, inner orbital complex. In case of this, so the same thing here, the oxidation state of cobalt in COF3, F6 is plus 3 only, again with 3d6, 6 electrons are present in d orbital of cobalt plus 3. While in the presence of fluoride, as we know, fluoride is a weak field ligand, the energy difference between Eg and T2g is less, delta 0 or delta O value is less, where delta O value is high.